I have to admit, sometimes I really love these opportunities because it gets me to think about what I need, and therefore what I need is what I transfer into what I just assume our team needs. So this morning we're getting closer to the end of 2017, and a question that keeps popping up in my days right now, and I'm sure it's being asked of you as well, is, are you ready? And the question when they say, are you ready, is of course they mean pertaining to, are you ready for the big day, like Christmas that's anticipating for everybody. And are you ready has been resonating in my head. When I go to sleep, I hear, are you ready? And when I wake up, I hear, are you ready? And it's been something that I've taken into other aspects of my life. And so I was thinking about who's ready for 2018. I know I am super excited about 2018. I know what's coming down the pipe. I know that Dawn and I have put pen to paper a little bit, and we have our plan. But I just wanted everyone that was listening in today to think a little bit about whether you're ready. And when we're talking about that in aspect to Christmas, and people say, are you ready for Christmas? I'm a firm believer that you're never ready for Christmas. You just run out of time. Christmas is like the amazing race for women. It's probably like that for a lot of people, but I find especially for women, the amazing race takes place, and there's so many things in our head that we want to do that we think is going to make the most amazing Christmas, whether it be baking and Christmas cards and Christmas pictures. And what happens is you run out of time. You don't get absolutely every little perfect thing that you thought ready, and nobody is none the wiser. They think it was the most perfect, beautiful Christmas ever, and the only person that often feels disappointed in that is the person that has the mindset that it should have been more. And networking can be a lot like that. So what I wanted to use it as an example is there's a lot of people that just like me that thinks that if I had the perfect Christmas picture, if I had the perfect Christmas cookie, or if dinner goes flawless without any problems, that it's going to be the perfect Christmas. With networking, people can think in their heads, if I had the right words, or if I had the right timing, or if I had the right competence, that then I could be successful. I just want you to stop and think, it's been my experience that the words help, and if the timing's right, that helps too. And confidence can be amazing, but avoiding it altogether is kind of like canceling Christmas, don't you think? I mean, there's so much of that that happens every day in everything that we do in networking, in Christmas, in what we imagine that moment needs to be. And it doesn't have to be. It can just be as amazingly successful as getting started and moving forward. So my advice on the threshold of 2018 is to kind of make a plan. Write down some of your goals. If, like the scenario that I was talking about, if what you need is the words, find the words. If what you need is competence, find that competence. And make the time. That's what 2018 is going to be. Don't sit on the fence waiting for those perfect moments, because it's only perfect in your head. It's going to be, your success is going to come in the action. And I always say the learning is in the doing, and I'm a big believer in that. For me, I also have been thinking this morning, I was thinking about the emotions that you have when you're a child on Christmas morning, and it's so magical, isn't it, when you're a little kid, and the joy, the curiosity, the excitement, the anticipation, the real strong one there is hope, like the hope that one thing or that one special thing is going to be there. Those are pretty amazing emotions. What if I told you that when you fulfill your dreams, when you get to where you need to be, when you get to that point where you achieve freedom, flexibility, independence, ability to do what you want to do, when you want to do, with who you want to do it with, that same feeling that you have when you're a little kid on Christmas morning, that feeling is the same thing that you get when you accomplish the dreams that you want to accomplish. So what I really need you to do to get ready for 2018 is I want you to want that dream more than you want your excuses. And it can be something that's really amazing. I imagine a life that you live without the hassles and the hurdles of everyday life living. I know that that might sound unimaginable, and I tell people all the time, people that have forgotten how to dream, people that just put their nose to the grindstone and do what they've been doing, they have such a hard time imagining. It's like the commercials that they do when you win the lottery, right? Where you're waking up and you're on the boat and you're shaving and you're having breakfast and you're doing something that seems completely unimaginable. Well, I want to tell you guys right now today that I bet you there was a day when somebody in our team by the name of Brett Griffin couldn't imagine being able to spend as much time with his family and his children as he's managed to do. And he's a double diamond in our company, and he now has the independence to be able to stay at home and be active, participating in his children's lives. I don't know if any of you saw his latest post where he was able to get a puppy for his kids, but his kids have wanted a puppy for a really long time, and he thought it would be unfair to do that, to have that as a goal. When he was working and Andrea was working such long hours, the kids were at school, and he said, it's not really fair to a puppy. And this year is the first year where he was able to fulfill that dream. And that might not be your dream, but it was his kids' dream. And when he gave that puppy to his children the other day, he was here at our home. There wasn't a dry eye in the house because we knew what that meant. That was just another aspect of his dream being fulfilled. And it moves me. It makes me want this even more. It makes me want to tell everybody that there's a better way, and the better way is what we have to look forward to in 2018. We have to focus on what we want, that why. Dawn has said so many times, focus on your why. Maybe your why isn't passionate enough. A lot of people say if your why doesn't make you cry, then it's not going to keep you to do what you need to do every single day. And I want everyone to have that feeling again, that feeling that you have Christmas morning, that first time when you're a little kid. I know for me, Christmas morning was magical, and I want to plug back into it. And the only thing that comes close is when I see people fulfilling these dreams, and I just cannot tell you how empowering that is. So some of the things that you have to do is you got to write down your goals. When was the last time you wrote down some goals? I know that we put our pen to paper every now and then, but I think it should be something that you do over and over again. Our daughter just recently, she wasn't a big believer in writing down her goals. And, of course, she has Nancy and Dawn Carson as her parents. And so we told her about the power of just writing down some of your goals. And I'm not talking about the fact that you have to write down that I'm going to be the prime minister one day, that it has to be something completely so far into the future. What she wrote down was two really big things for her was she said, I want to get my driver's license. And she wrote it down, and I want to play on a competitive volleyball team. And guess what? In this last week, she's fulfilled both of those goals. And I truly, honestly believe it's in the power of writing them down. And it is just unbelievable when you focus on something and you come back to it and you make it important to you and you make it important in your heart. It's like so many of us that make ourselves not that important. We put ourselves last on the to-do list. Don't put your dreams last on your to-do list. It is so important in 2018 that you need to do what you need to do to be successful. You don't need to watch another episode of Game of Thrones. You don't need to binge watch some Netflix program. You do need to focus on what is going to get you to your end result. And what is going to get you to your end result? Talking to new people, introducing them to your opportunity. That's what's going to make it happen. That is the only way that you can be successful in this business, is you have to introduce people to what you're doing. And the only way you can do that is by talking to them. So I want everybody to focus on that in 2018. I want you to look at your DMO. How is it going? Don and I have the tools all set up on Team Gets Result, our Facebook page, and we can help you with that. If you are struggling with your DMO, if you're thinking your daily method of operation is lacking, then plug into your upline and ask us what we think you need to do, and we will try our very, very best to get you in the right direction, to help you so that you know what you need to do every day to get to where you need to be. So I want everyone to plug into your why, and I want you to want your dream more than your excuses. It's really, really important. And I had a few things happen in the last week that made me realize something, just a mindset of thinking. I want everyone to get back to your basics. I wonder if some of you have said the same things a million times and you think that you've told people what you've told them, or maybe they've just forgotten what you've told them, so you got to kind of go back and readdress it. It's really, really important. The process, the basics of what got us to be where we are, it's the process. It's duplicatable. So we don't try and reinvent the wheel. We just keep doing the same process, and that's where the success comes from. And sometimes the people that you've already told these things to need to get reengaged with a connect call, and they need to hear it again from your upline. And I'm wondering if you're on here, Sherry, if we can start to, if you could put your hand, oh, here we are. I'll unmute you. Sherry, are you there?
I'm here. Can you hear me, Nancy?
Yes, I can. Sherry, awesome. Can you tell everybody that I know that we did a call today, and I readdressed what you had already told this person a million times. I know you've told this person a million times. And where was the magic in what happened today?
Well, I spoke to this. She's a preferred customer of mine, and she's just been, I've told her and told her over and over again different things. And so today I'm like, I need to connect her with Nancy. So we got on this call, and everything Nancy said, I've already spoke to her with, and she just said out of the blue, oh my gosh, a light bulb just went off. So it's just the reevaluation, the power of a connect call and having that third party validation, because it doesn't matter if you're friends with them or not, just having that extra person in there just solidifies what's going on. It was just great. I just get goosebumps talking about it, because it was just like, wow, she just got it.
Right, and I've said so many times, and Don and I will say on multiple occasions, how magical the three-way call is. And I know we call it connect call, three-way call. You can call it whatever kind of call it is. People want to talk to people. So the best thing you can do, even if you just get on the phone and have a conversation with her, I never really had what I would call a connect call experience with this woman. I just told her what you had already told her. But I told her. So it reinforced what you said. And also, it's really nice to hear it. I know that there's a lot of people that believe in automation and the way that that happens. But I really do believe that there is a certain power that comes from just picking up the phone and talking to somebody. And that they can hear in your tone. They can hear in what you're saying. And it just somehow, like you said, she had a light bulb go off. That happens in the magic of conversation, and it happens in the magic of conversation only. So I just cannot reinforce enough how important it is to either personally yourself call people and reengage with them every now and then and see how things are going, and also to connect your upline just sporadically every now and then just to reconnect.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Excellent. I'm so glad that I was able to help you out with that, Sherry. And I'm just going to cover a few things here quickly of some of the basics that I think that that we've maybe forgotten. So I'm just going to mute you here again, Sherry.
Okay.
I'm going to cover some of these. Okay. So some of the basics that we have forgotten possibly, or we think that we've said them to people, or they've just become like a mantra. So the simple points are Valentus is a point, click, and share company. What does that mean? Well, we're information directors. We point you in the direction of a website, and then you get to make a choice of where you fit in. Get in where you fit in. That decision is made ultimately by the person independently of you. I love that part. They get to choose whether they're coming in at 1, 3, 6, or 16 boxes. We always talk about the advantages of a business builder pack. And what are the advantages of a business builder pack? Well, number one, it qualifies you for all levels of the comp plan, which is really good when you're wanting to get paid or you're wanting someone to get paid and they can be paid on the following Friday right after they sign up. It gives you enough product to take and sample and create your story to be a product of the product. That's an incredible tool. Another thing that people have maybe slipped their minds to mention to people, how important it is to take a before and after picture. Some people go digging for their before and after pictures, but it's an incredible tool. It can be very advantageous, especially in social media. Number three, shows the government you are legitimate as a business for tax benefits. You tell me if you're sitting across from somebody that's auditing you, that if you told them that you started your business with one box of product, that they would seriously consider you more than just a tire kicker. There is something to be said with starting in your company with a business builder pack. You are legitimately going into business for yourself. The best option on the return policy. Your first order is 90 days, so you get more product for more time to make your decision because every day, every order after that is a 30-day return policy. So those are just some of the points for why the business builder pack is imperative and easy, and this is the bare bones minimum of the simplicity stuff that we need to re-engage and tell people about just in case they forgot. Your loyalty purchase is based on personal consumption. Three boxes to maintain your rake is asking people to be a product of the product. I know some people, I've actually had people call me up and they said, I just have such a hard time talking to people about the loyalty purchase. And for me, honestly, I think truthfully that it comes from competence. If the person that is talking to them sounds like they're asking them to do something, I always go in with the business builder pack with unwavering confidence that that's the best and only really good choice going forward. And I speak the same way about my loyalty purchase. I mean, it gets you ready. It gets you, it qualifies you for getting paid and you're being a product of the product. If you love the products like I do, I absolutely love these products. Being a product of the product is exactly what you want everyone to be. So it comes with confidence. And that's where I think that you just have to be. Your mindset has to be there. And you have to be unwavering in how imperative it is, how amazing it is, how true residual income is stemmed from becoming a product of the product and loving the products, really, really loving them. I love that in Valentus we don't have any catalogs or order forms. If you're talking to somebody that's coming from another network marketing company that had catalogs or order forms, I got to tell you, that's a huge selling feature. It is a winna-winna chicken dinner to somebody that has spent a small fortune on catalogs and training materials and that they have to, every time there's a new product introduced, order new catalogs, new order forms, new everything. The process is painful. I love that all of our products are the same price. I love that fact. Sometimes we forget to talk about it. I never forget to talk about that all our products, you just add water, except for now our Prevail Max and our Canine, which is like a super convenient spray-ceutical that is incredible, and the testimonials that come back on a daily basis just blow my mind. And if I ever, ever have any kind of questioning as to my mindset, I just plug into a testimonial page on Facebook for a little while, whether it be Prevail Max. I love the stories on Canine. I mean, if you're a dog lover, how do you read those stories and not get emotional? I know that they make me feel all day, every day. And the Prevail Max testimonials are just incredible. So that's something that you can talk about all the time, that the products are so super simple. And the product comes right to your doors. There's no deliveries. Have you ever known anyone that was an Avon lady, and so she would order all of the deliveries, all of her products, and then she would go door-to-door to deliver them? I love that we don't have to do that, that nothing's required. We're not a diet. We don't come with a workout video, but often when you have more energy, which our products give you, more activity is just what happens in your life. So you don't have to become more active, but it seems like an inevitable evolution of who you're becoming, because when you're becoming more healthy, it seems like activity is just going to be the next thing. And if you're talking with this enthusiasm about your products and you're talking about your company with this enthusiasm, you can hear in my voice how amazing I think Valentus is. The company has a built-in follow-up system. You just pre-enroll people and the magic begins. I love that. And it just gives you a basis point. There's so many people that struggle with the follow-up. So it's essential, but it's something that you need to do, and the company gets the ball rolling for you. Because with some people, the learning is in the doing, and they haven't figured that out yet, so they have to plug into that part. They need to figure out how to follow up, but the company already starts that ball going for you. I love that. You have no sales goals required in Valentus. And our comp plan rewards you for consuming the products. That is a comparison point for people that are saying, well, you know, I'm kind of looking at this other thing. If you're sitting on the fence, you go through these points with somebody, and I can guarantee you that their company or what they're looking at is not bringing these incredible, incredible points. We have unbelievable support and training at no cost to you. I love that. Everybody can get onto a call. You can plug into the Valentus calls. There's so many team calls that you can get onto, videos, webinars, Zooms. There's events available to you all the time at no cost to you. There's so many other companies that charge everybody for their training. I only bring this stuff up because I think we can get stuck in the process that something isn't working anymore, but maybe you've just lost your enthusiasm as to how simple and amazing this company is, and you've stepped away from what works, or you're reinventing the wheel. Don't reinvent the wheel. The process is working. The most amazing thing about John Haremza's book, Right or Almost Right, is the simplicity and the duplication. John is one of the most consistent presenters in Valentus I've seen. His message is always the same. He knows what works. He delivers the same message over and over and over. And some of you might think that you need to keep it fresh, but you don't need to keep your presentation fresh, and you don't need to keep anything different about your presentation. What you need to keep fresh is you. Keep you fresh with personal growth and keep the message consistent. And be enthusiastic and love what you're doing. Listen to people, create connections, acknowledge objections, and offer solutions. Valentus solves problems. We can give you more time, more money, and better health. Those are three major factors in people's lives on a daily basis. I am so excited that I got to share with you tonight. And I was just writing down a few things, and I was trying to picture if I was to put into a box like a Christmas present, because my presentation today and what I've been talking to you was Christmas themed. I want you to imagine a life filled with the vitality of achievement and the enrichment of daily self-fulfillment. To me, for a long time, that kind of life sounded impractical. Dream of a cardboard box filled up with daydreams and wishes to live a life of hope, promise, expectation, and achievement was only to live the life of someone who lived in the pages of a book. This is my present to you. I want you to imagine your box full of achievement, enrichment, self-fulfillment. These are the things that will carry you through every little thing and get you to where you need to be. The magical excitement of dreams. That's what Christmas time is all about. That's what I want you guys to plug into you. Valentus has allowed Dawn and I to dream, and I want you to come along with us on our dream. I know that I have cut it a little short tonight, but I was really, really enjoying my moment with you, and I hope you guys got something from our call this evening. Thank you very much for chiming in on this wonderful end of 2017. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm filling my cardboard box with lots of good stuff for 2018. So I hope you've got that visual message in your head and you're taking that with you. And I can't wait to talk to you guys again. Talk to you soon.